Oh, hello, guys, and welcome to Some Burnout Battle Plays Yu-Gi-Oh! Legacy of the Duelist, Keith's Math and Machinations, Joey versus Bandit Keith. The second semifinal match was Joey versus Bandit Keith. In order to compete in the duel, each contestant had to present his tournament entry card, which Joey shockingly did not have. Unknown to Joey, Bandit Keith stole Joey's entry card the night before. Per the rules of the tournament, Joey was granted 5 minutes to find his card or be disqualified. Joey searched everywhere, but was unable to find it. On his way back to the arena, he broke down in the hallway. Sorry, sis. I came close. Real close. Get up off the floor, Joey, and quit all your crying already. You look like a big baby. Who's crying? I got something in my eye. Stupid thing won't come out. Mai handed him her handkerchief. Here, just don't go blowing your nose in it. You know, every time I think I've got you figured, you surprise me. Huh? Taya told me about your little sister. How you're dueling to win the tournament's prize money for her so she can have that operation. Sounded like a bad soap opera, to be honest, but then who doesn't love a bad soap opera? Anyway, see you around, hun. As Mai walked away, Joey noticed she had hidden her tournament entry card in the handkerchief. Wait, Mai! Take it. I don't need it anymore. One thing, though. Uh-huh. Take Bandit Keith down. Joey ran back to the arena. So, the punks come to give us the bad news, huh? Let me guess. You couldn't find that card anywhere. What are you talking about? I got it right here. All right, Keith, time to duel. Fine. You know, a part of me wanted you to show up. A nice little warm-up match might do me some good. I'll warm you up and wear you out. Tell me how it feels to be an amateur going up against the Intercontinental Dueling Champion. Oh, the Intercontinental Championship. I could win a better prize than that in a box of cereal. Punk, I'll teach you to respect my title. Damn. That was actually a really good burn by Joey. It makes me happy when, like, TV actually has good insults. Especially cartoons. Okay, first to go, Joey Wheeler versus Bandit Keith. Now, Bandit Keith's a dick-ass bitch because he has Barrel Dragon, and that pisses me off. Obviously. Alright, we've got a bunch of fusion cards. What else do we have? Thousand Dragon, Guilty of the D-Knight, Guardian of the Labyrinth, Protector of the Throne, and Flame Swordsman. Okay. Some fusion cards, I just don't know why they exist. Like, this is just isn't good enough. Flame Swordsman? It's not good. There are 4-star cards that have higher attack than that are better all around. I don't know, man. Only a fire monster against 700 attack. Salamandra would be good. I think we'll save Flame Manipulator for Flame Swordsman just because then we can equip it with Salamandra. And then we'll have a... I hate when Mystical Space Typhoon is in my hand, though, because it's another one of those things where, like, it will prompt you constantly to use it, no matter what. At least as long as he's got some kind of magic card somewhere. Terraforming, and then you'll use Mausoleum of the Emperor. And then you pay 2,000 just so you can immediately get Zoa. That's a pretty good field card. You know, it's risk, high risk, high reward, especially if I then destroy the field card, which I am about to do. I need to read the entire effect of that card, though. Max 2,000. That player normal summon sets that monster without tributing. This is their one normal summon set for that turn. This is not a tribute summon. Okay. So wouldn't... Okay, well, I get it then. Zoa. 1,800 plus 7. That's, even if I got Flame Swordsman with Salamandra, that would not be enough to kill Zoa. Unfortunately. Baby Dragon. If we could get Time Wizard, that still wouldn't be enough to kill Zoa. We have ourselves in a relatively precarious situation. If you've got another Terraformer, you're probably going to get another Mausoleum of the Emperor. Nope, you're not even putting anything down. Okay, now you're putting stuff down. Why bother? Why don't you just use main phase 1 to put shit down? It stops bothering me. Guardian of the Labyrinth. What a why? Oh, wait, isn't that a fusion card, too? Isn't that for, like, Guilty of the D-Knight? Yeah, Guardian, okay. So we've got a ton of fusion monsters for all different kinds of my fusions right now. Which means we basically do have to... Plus, I don't even have Polymerization. I have to sacrifice, or, it, well, not sacrifice, but, like, set that one, because that's the fusion I care about the least. The only way I'm going to turn this around is if I get Time Wizard and activate its effect properly. Okay, now we've got Flame Swordsman. Except we still don't have Polymerization, so actually, never mind. We'll just keep on setting this shit, I guess. Even though we're winning, this duel doesn't look good for me. We're only winning because Bandit Keith made it so, by sacrificing his own life points. So come on now, man. I need me... Great, what are you... Is that selecting a spell card? You can use it in, as your hand until the end of the turn. If you use it, it takes 4,000. If I had, like, a major... Does Joey have red eye... Joey has Red Eyes Black Dragon at this point. But that still wouldn't be enough to kill Zoa. But if I had a monster that was high enough to kill Zoa, I could use Grave Robber to put his Mausoleum of the Emperor on my side of the field, and then I could pay... That would be, like, 4,000 life points that I'd have to spend in order to summon a monster that was better than Zoa. But we don't even have that, so still, it is kind of moot. Unfortunately, we don't have Polymerization, so now I have to continue to ruin my fusions. What other spells? You don't have any other spell cards. Oh, Terraforming was your other one that's in there. I'm not going to spend 2,000 life points to use Terraforming. I'm not even sure I have Sojin in my deck. Although with Sojin and Flame Swordsman and Salamandra, I would have enough to kill Zoa. Unfortunately, we're just going to have to use Sakuritsu Armor to kill Zoa, which works just as well for me. Aw, you dick! Isn't Mystical Space Typhoon forbidden? I feel like it might be. There's Palmer. Just a bit too late for Palmerization, man. I need, like, a monster reborn. Some Mystical Space Typhoon. I could. But why? There's no reason for that. There's no reason. I'm gonna have to sacrifice many, many life points right now. Just because I'm still holding out hope for Misaki the Legendary Swordsman to be my next card. And it's not. Normal summons or flip summons. That won't kill Zoa, though. That'll just kill another one of his cards. He doesn't have... There's nothing we can do. There's nothing we can do! All I can do is I can hold out one more turn by killing if he decides to summon something else. Unless he has another Mystical Space Typhoon. Which... Ah, you dick. So that's what you had. Well... Use the opponent's Mausoleum of the Emperor to bring out your own high-level monsters. Okay. If I had any, that's definitely what I would have done. Still using the story decks. Okay, Bandit Keith. Okay, Bandit Keith. We've got you, we've got Polymerization. I'm gonna put that down right now. Active, what? Are you kidding? They're trying to make me use Mystical Space Typhoon to kill my own trap card? And that's gonna be the prompt for, like, the rest of everything. Oh my god, why would I want to do that? I know why it would be useful sometimes to kill my own spell or trap card, but why? Oh, Launcher Spider. Okay. Yeah, please, by all means, sacrifice 2,000 of your own life points just so I can kill the monster you just activated. So sorry. Oh my god, there's way too many of those. I don't like it. Trap hole. Yeah, I need to get rid of... I am going to destroy Mausoleum of the Emperor. Just, it benefits him a lot more than it benefits me. That's why I think that's it. That's why. Pector of the Throne. We're gonna have to. I think we'll set Trap Hole. Just because I bet anything one of those is Mystical Space Typhoon, so we'll just force it to reveal itself. And Birthright. Oh, that's cheap as hell. No, let's not continue to attack. How about that? It counts as a special summon, otherwise that would have been nice. Well, we're gonna lose some life points now. Kunai with Chain, unfortunately, is still not gonna help me. I could activate Time Wizard to try to kill it, but that could also very well ensure my own demise. It's all we have, unfortunately. Call it right! It's gonna be Tails. Fuck! God damn it. Okay, when one or both, when an opponent's monster declares an attack, change that target to defense position. Okay, so we're gonna set this because that's gonna save me a bit. That's gonna save me for one turn. Maybe give me something to bring, come back. Yes. Okay. That protected me a bit. And then we can set some cards. And really just ride this completely out, because again, you know, it would be super nice if we just had some kind of advantage from the start that we could ride all the way to the end. But, of course, we don't. Flame I want... Although I don't have Salamandra or anything yet still. So again, like, we're gonna keep getting our fusion materials, but we keep having to sacrifice them. And now that thing's even stronger than it was before. Oh, but at least I got Metamorph. If it attacks, it gains attack equal to half the attack of the attack target during damage calculation only. Alright, we're about to lose some life points here. Do you not summon because you expect this to be, you expect this to be Trap Hole? I don't know. Nope, can't do anything about that, so we surrender. So yeah, surrender and then you still get your consolation prize. Pendulum Machine. Consolation, dual points. Let's try it again. If we lose again, I'm gonna use my user deck that I've made that is guaranteed to win. And when I say guaranteed, I mean I made myself a very, very nice deck. Okay. I've made a bunch of decks. I'm fine-tuning those. But this one that I'm talking about really can't, to the best of my knowledge, get any better. Alright, 2,000 so you can summon Barrel Dragon. Oh, now I can summon Red Eyes Black Dragon. Unfortunately. Yeah, I can activate its effect to do that. It's not strong enough, so... what's the point, right? Okay, so... we're gonna set down Trap Hole. And we're gonna start by activating Time Wizard. Now I'm a negative Nancy, so I think Tails is gonna hit. Yes! Oh, beauteous. Oh, beauteous, beauteous. And we're gonna battle with it. 500 attack, baby. Oh, another 2,000 for you. That's cool. Let me just, trap hole that shit. Oh, I'm so sorry. Nice. Alright, baby dragon and time wizard. Unfortunately, we don't have polymerization, or we could make... that would be really nice, actually. Alright, we're gonna activate our own Mausoleum of the Emperor. I'm gonna donate 2,000 life points. So that we may summon Red Eyes Black Dragon. Attack. And attack. And yeah, that counts as a normal summon, it's not a special summon. So we couldn't summon another monster. But this looks pretty bad for Bandit Keith. That was weird. You got rid of it and then put that face down. You didn't want me to be able to activate another thing, but you're going to be prepared to flip that face up if, again, you get a monster that would benefit. No, because you can't even do it because you don't have the life points for it. So that's why you got rid of it. Because now it's only benefiting me. Oh, but would you look at this shit. Palmerization, Thousand Dragon, Baby Dragon, Time Wizard. Now this is bringing out the potential of the Joey deck. Good job. Attack position, huh? And then we'll just keep those. Bye-bye, Bandit Keith. That was super easy, and I enjoyed it. No way! He beat me! This duel doesn't count! That entry card that Joey showed to play in this match wasn't even his! Therefore, the duel shouldn't count, and he ought to be disqualified right here! He's right, my card was missing, so Mai gave me hers. But tell me, Keith, how could you have known this wasn't my card? I'm all in, so why don't you explain yourself? He doesn't need to. It's clear that Keith stole Joey's card. That's why he was so certain that you would never be able to find it. Take the scoundrel away. Far away. No! Birthright, Mausoleum of the Emperor, Time Machine. Alright. And now it's Joey versus... Yugi versus Joey. So let's do this. With Joey winning against Bandit Keith, it was now time for the final duel of the tournament. It was Joey versus Yugi. Best friends, both dueling for great causes. I have to win this match so that I can duel Pegasus and save my grandpa. But to get to Pegasus, I have to beat my best friend Joey. I have to win this for my sister's serenity. Yug, I hope you don't have any second thoughts about dueling me. I'm sorry, Joey, but I don't know if I can do this. Suck it up, Yugi. You said it yourself that if it came down to us, we'd both just play our best and most honorable duel. That's the only way we're really going to know which one of us is best prepared to take on Pegasus in the final match. So let's duel. Okay, maybe Joey is right. I may not want to do this, but still, it has to be done if we want to beat Pegasus. What do you say, Yug? Let's do this thing. All right, Joey, time to duel. Bam, 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 bam. Let's see if Joey can use his fusions to stop me. I don't think he'll be able to, but that's just my opinion. I am the champion duelist, of course. Okay, we got actually something real nice. So you can add polymerization to your hand if you don't have any fusions that you make right now, though. But I do, so, you know, good for me. Why don't we just activate that effect, huh? Make ourselves a Gaia the Dragon champion. If only I had another monster. Unfortunately, I have to treat my special summon as just a regular old summon. Two attack position. Alright, during your opponent's choose one, two, I gotta remember this. Choose two, no monster, one monster. You shove those three cards and set them in the field. The two cards chosen from your deck are treated as normal monsters and are destroyed at the end of the battle phase. We don't need to do that yet. Alright, what are you? Ah, Time Wizard. Very glad that I got rid of that. Because that's like the one thing that when the enemy gets Time Wizard, they get it right, like, probably 90% of the time. Mike of the Magical Mist. is good if I got Summon Skull. But I don't have Summon Skull. Oh, Flame Manipulator. I know you got Polymerization in your hand, so you really must be struggling to get two of the same fusion requirement. If I had to guess, I would say that that's Kunai with Chain. I don't need to summon Karibo. It is not Kunai with Chain. But maybe you're saving it for a situation in which you could then take advantage of the fact that my Dragon Champion would be in defense mode if you had a monster that had like 2200 attack or something like that. Alright, Summoner's Art can add one level 5 or higher. Oh, we're going to combine this with Ancient Rules to basically just immediately summon our super high level thing right now. How about Dark Magician? Dark Magician seems like the best choice. Then we'll use Ancient Rules to summon Dark Magician in attack mode. Then we will equip Dark Magician with Book of Secret Arts. And now I beg you to think of a way to stop me. Oh, we just won. That was the fastest duel that has ever been recorded in Duelist history. I know it actually wasn't, but, you know. Well, Yugi, we knew one of us had to lose, but the good news is one of us got the win, too. Congratulations, man. Here, take my Glory of the King's hand card. Show it to Pegasus's flunky croquet, and I'll give you $3 million in prize money. No, Joey, you keep it. Your sister needs that money. Yug, I didn't enter this tournament to get rich, Joey. I'm just here to save my grandpa and the Kaiba brothers. Please, use this money for Serenity's operation. When I lost the duel, I lost all hope for saving my sister. But now, Yugi, thank you. Now go and take down Pegasus. Is it really like corrective eye surgery $3 million? I think they really downplay the fact that Joey should be like totally fucking rich after that. Oh, but they gave us a lot of good cards there. Not cards that I didn't already have, but I think I only had one Summon Skull, so it's nice to get more. I've been really investing in the card shop. They give you tons of points to spend in the card shop. Like, it's almost too many points. But at the same time, like, once you really get into the, like, trying to hunt for specific cards, you could eat those points up really fast. The time had finally come. As champion of the Duelist Kingdom Tournament, Yugi won the right to duel Maximilian Pegasus. Promise me that you will free the souls of my grandfather and all the others. Yes, but if I am the one that defeats you instead, you have to fulfill your end of the bargain as well. Take a close look at the card you hold in your hand, Yugi boy. There's a reason why it's blank. For if I win, I claim your soul forever. You have much to gain, but much at risk as well. It's a risk I'm willing to take to free the souls of my grandpa and the others. But I don't plan to lose. I hate to disappoint you, Pegasus, but I have no intention of ever becoming a part of your soul card collection. Story deck. You know Pegasus's deck. It's filled with toon monsters and it's all bullshit. Let's see just how well we can do against that. I'll be first to go, as I always am wont to do. It's nice because I'm using these recordings also as a way to, like, subversively gain chips or points that I can use to, like, try to build my decks that I'm having trouble completing right now. So, you know, this fulfills dual purposes, and I enjoy that. Okay, so we'll just set you. I think we're going to immediately do Swords of Revealing Light just so we can get Summon Skull on the field without risk of Celtic Guardian dying. I bet you have Toon World, like, instantly. Yes, you do. It's weird that that's not a field card. Don't you think Toon World should be a field card? No, I guess not. Because then it would help both of us. And, like, we would need our separate things. But, okay, this card cannot attack. Turn it to summon. Toon World is destroyed. You destroy the while you control Toon World. And your opponent controls no monsters. This card can attack. If this card inflicts battle damage. Okay, so there's nothing bad if I kill it, which I plan to do right now. Okay, so we'll battle them. Please don't have Mirror Force. What? Oh, another safe zone. Chain safe zone. Chain safe zone. Okay. I think that just makes it so it can't be destroyed, but you can still attack it. On the field, that face-up monster cannot be targeted or destroyed by your opponent's card effects or by battle. It cannot attack your opponent directly. When this card leaves the field, destroy that monster with it. Okay. So, yeah. That I can't kill the card unless I kill these things. Wait, is it by... Yeah, by card effects or... Yeah, I can't Dark Hole it to kill it either. Which is okay. And the fact that you have two of them chained to that means that, like, I need Spell Shattering Arrow. And I know Yugi's got it, so... Oh, fuck. No! No, no, no. You don't get to fuse and make Thousand Eyes Restrict, though. Oh, but you do get to do that! Oh, shit. Okay, we need... Yeah. So, now what I need Spell Shattering Arrow. Spell Shattering Arrow is not going to kill trap cards, by the way. But I do need Spell Shattering Arrow, because then it'll kill Summon Skull, then I could Monster Reborn that Summon Skull. That would be nice. Unfortunately, you've got all that right now. So this does not look good, because it isn't. I am waiting for a card that can turn this around for me. Yeah, defense mode, because you still can't attack, but now you can attack. But it's my turn, so I need something to happen right now. My Kuza, don't I have... Target one, but I control. Fuck. You took that from me, you son of a bitch. Set Feral Imp. And Faye is not looking good. Not... He can be really annoying when he's got that Thousand Eyes Restrict going on. And Relinquished as well. Okay, I need Dark Hole even though it won't kill the one in the middle. Because I need these guys to die. Okay, so now what's going to happen... is I'm going to set this monster, and then I'm going to end my phase, and then maybe we lose. If you summon another Toon monster that has, like, really high attack. But you didn't. So we're not losing yet. Mystic Box! And one monster I control. Destroy the first target, then give control of the second target to your opponent. That's actually exactly the card that I needed. So we're going to activate that effect. I'm going to destroy that, which will also destroy Summon Skull. You can have my fucking Celtic Guardian. I don't give a shit. Then I'm going to use Monster Reborn to bring back my Summon Skull. In attack mode. Then, I'm going to use my Maiku the Magical Mist to kill all the monsters on the field whose defense is less than my Summon Skull. Except that one, of course, because that still can't be destroyed. Why can't I battle? Oh, come on. Oh, I don't remember. Toon Table of Contents. Add one Toon or Manga Ryurian from your card to your hand. Toon Table of Contents, which then allows you to add Toon Summon Skull to your hand. Which then you're going to do that. Are you going to... Does... Oh, destroys that. Okay, must be special summon. Are you going to... You must pay 500 life points to declare an attack. This card can attack your opponent directly unless they control a Toon monster. If they do control one, this target must target it. Okay, so next turn you're going to start attacking me directly, basically. Unless I sacrifice my Summon Skull to kill your Summon Skull. Which, unfortunately, seems to be exactly what I have to do. I don't like it. But at least, like, we're back on relatively equal playing field now. Stone Goblin Attack Force. Still can't attack the turn it's summoned, though. So that's the caveat of that. Black Magic Ritual. Ritual Summon Magician of Black Chaos. You must also true. Shit. That's not helping me. Not helping me right now. In defense mode for some reason. Alright, but that does turn you into defense mode, which... Okay, give me something that can kill that, please. Thank you! That's actually really nice. Because your Toon Mermaid can't kill it either. Just pay 500... Oh, but yeah, all Toon monsters can attack directly, so it doesn't really matter. I guess. But yeah, let's kill you. I cannot believe I have not gotten Spell-Shattering Arrow yet. Or just even, like, a D-spell of some kind. I may have to sacrifice Winged Dragon. Nope, I can't. Instead, what I have to do... Oh, no. I can't... It's pointless to tribute for Catapult Turtle if I can't do anything with it. I have to switch to battle phase and kill Toon Mermaid. Otherwise, it's going to attack me directly again. At least if he summons another Toon Monster, it can't attack on the turn it's summoned. Okay, and that's still not even strong enough. Oh, yes, please. Okay, that's nice. Unfortunately, I still can't put anything down. Based on the drawing of that card, it would have been better... Well, now you just got fucking Toon World again. It would have been better to let Toon Mermaid attack me on the next turn, and then I would have had a monster to attack him again, and we could make this better. But... I can still attack directly. I can't win now. So I have to surrender. Yes, I surrender. Wait for Pegasus to summon Toon Monsters before destroying Toon World. I understand that. But with that particular thing, I know it's 32 minutes. I'm going to try it again. I don't care. I don't care, man. I did a really good chain move to bring back that summon skull and to turn it around. But then, you know, he's still just got his Toon stuff. Kind of difficult. So, let's just see how it goes this time. Alright, it's always good to start with Graceful Charity. We got Mirror Force and Monster Reborn, that's good. So we're gonna get rid of you. I'm not getting rid of Black Magic Ritual. I'm not getting rid of Guy of the Fierce Knight. I guess I'll get rid of Griffor. I don't need to put up Mirror Force yet, because if you do... Okay. That's the biggest waste I think I've ever seen. But you don't have Toon World. While you control... So you can treat it as normal monster... Okay, well, anyway. I'll turn you into attack one to kill you, and then I guess we'll put up Mirror Force now. Still can't do... Oh, don't do that yet. Change to attack position. Kill you. Toon Gemini can't attack me directly, at least not yet. Copycat's kind of annoying. Basically, just like use it to activate the effect. Yeah, as a matter of fact. Why don't we Mirror Force? And destroy... That's so annoying. Wow, what an asshole. Although, for these purposes right now, that's probably the best card you could have gotten rid of. Maybe I need Dark Bribe. Because when I play against John, he uses fucking Mirror Force every friggin' duel. Anyway. Okay. Let's see. I could kill them. I could use Monster Reaver to bring that back. And there's a Cannibal Turtle, but that would be pointless. 13 damage, but you still wouldn't be able to kill it, per se. Unfortunately, we don't have much of a choice. I don't want to waste Monster Reborn. Bringing back Giant Soldier of Stone just to block your guys' attacks. But we don't really have a choice. Oh, you know, I could do Torike. And then put Magical Hats. And then that's a stall tactic that I could use. So I think I will. It is the battle phase. Activate the effect of a card. Choose two non-monster and one monster you control. That one. And then also, we'll get rid of Advanced Ritual Art and Black Magic Ritual. Yeah, because we're still going to have the ability to ritualize things. Alright, are you gonna attack the right one? That's so gay. Oh well, it still succeeded in preventing battle damage. So I guess that was the point. I could also use you to prevent battle damage. 13 is in, but I could sacrifice that for Catapult Turtle. But again, as I'm still trying to avoid that. You're gonna want Ritual Monster or Ritual Spell card from your deck to your hand. Oh, do not start that Relinquish bullshit with me. Karibo, go ahead and block the highest attack thing from there. We're still gonna take damage. I know, but we lessened it a bit. Something nice, please. That is not nice. Oh my god. We got that. So if you ritualize, now we don't have a choice. And these are like the only monsters that we have in defense position. And I could, but that would be, it's still the same thing. So there's no reason to do that. Just hopefully I can block him. Yeah, it appears so. Oh, there's Magician of Black Chaos. Unfortunately, I got rid of my Magician of my Black Magic Ritual stuff. Which is unfortunate, because I could use these two cards to make that happen. Okay. Let's face up. End our phase again. There's nothing to be done yet. Just playing the waiting game right now. I would love a Dark Hole right now. Or a Regieki, you know, I wouldn't be. I just say Dark Hole because Dark Hole is the less cheap version of Regieki. Okay, but we could. That Summon Skull is also very nice. Okay, that's what we got. Battle phase. Don't be Mirror Force, you dick in a box. Okay. Ow, Mirror Force 2, wow! Well, what do you know, guys? We just fucking lost. Yes, I surrender. I don't care how long this video is. We're gonna beat Pegasus. And as with what I said with Bandit Keith, we're gonna use the story deck one more time before I'm gonna switch to my uber powerful specialized deck that Maximilian Pegasus will not be able to stand up against, I guarantee. I've beaten him with that deck many times. Not a terrific draw, but maybe Graceful Charity will get me a better one. Dark Magician. And Horn of the Unicorn is very good. We got I don't need Palmerization. Based on what I have so far. I'm gonna keep Black Magic Ritual. I'm gonna get rid of Magical Hats. No, I'm gonna get rid of Karibo. Yeah, we'll get rid of Karibo. And then we'll set you... and keep Horn of the Unicorn just in case we'll need it, which we probably will. Yeah, well, okay, so you're gonna start your ritual stuff already. But you cannot ritual summon it yet. Oh, yes, you can. But you wanted to do it afterwards. After your battle phase, for some reason. Oh, because you wanted it to be face up, so it would actually give you the boosts. I've had him equip a face-down card, and it doesn't do anything. Okay, so you're now 13. But you're in defense mode, so that's going to be tougher to execute. But that's 700. That's not quite enough to kill you. It seems like... This is the issue that we face, is that if I use Horn of the Unicorn with Horn Imp in order to kill Manju of the 10,000 Hands, then once... Actually, no, you can't kill it. Okay, never mind. That was a debacle that was very unnecessarily needed. I'll activate Horn of the Unicorn. I was, for some reason, operating under the illusion that Horn Imp was somehow going to die instantly, no matter what, after this battle was over, which is not the case. Okay. Because Relinquished can't do anything to it. But I would now not be surprised if that is Mirror Force. Just to piss me off, man. Just to piss me off. And that's why I'm going to set this card. And I'm going to attack just to check. Although it makes sense that you don't have to use Mirror Force. That could be Mirror Force and you're just holding on to it. But I just wanted to see if maybe something would activate when I did that. Monster Reborn. Normal or Flip. That's special summon. You're not gonna get another ritual monster from that. So I can just re-kill that then. But I guess maybe you wanted to do it so I couldn't summon my Dark Magician, which is fair because that would have been the end of you. I don't need that. I'm gonna set it though, just to maybe make you nervous and want to try to waste one of your spell destroying cards to blow it up. Battle phase, kill you again. Oh, safe zone. I mean, that's actually kind of fine because it's such a weak card. I'll just keep attacking it and keep doing life point damage to you. I don't know why you'd want to protect that. Toon Goblin Attack Force is going to be annoying. God damn it. You're going to be able to kill my Horn Imp with that. And there's nothing I can do to stop here. Oh, that's a lie. Magical Hats gives me at least the opportunity to avoid death by that. But now you put it in defense mode and then now I definitely can't do anything. I guess we end our turn then. Okay, now you can attack me directly. And that's Toon Summon Skull probably. Yes, it is. But you can't attack with that just yet. is the battle phase. Activate the effect. What card? Oh yeah, magical hats. But if you're gonna attack me directly, is it even gonna work? Exactly, it's not. That's why it's pointless. Oh, but now, okay. Well, since you are choosing to attack that, then I will now use magical hats. Select one monster. We've already got black magic ritual. So we'll sacrifice the ones in my deck. Because it's totally fine if those die. Now, please. Oh, but that automatically kills Horn of the Unicorn? That was not supposed to do that. I mean, I guess I prevented some kind of calamity. Unfortunately, we're guaranteed to get Horn of the Unicorn on the next turn. And now we're about to take massive, massive damage. What are you doing? Oh, for a nut? Okay. Alright, well, less massive damage at least now. How about a dark hole? Spell shattering arrow. Yeah, actually, that's exactly something that's very nice. That's kind of better than dark hole, really. Okay, but, you know, we still have nothing. So, he probably could easily have another Tomb World. Tomb Goblin Attack Force. Can't attack, though. But now we finally have ourselves a Celtic Guardian. Something that I could summon. But even if I attack it with a statue, you know, it's not going to be enough. So, we have no choice but to set it. And end our phase! Come on, just give me Magician of Black Chaos, please. That's something that I could ritual summon and actually make something happen here. Okay, you chose not to attack for some reason. That's interesting. And good, but also mildly unhelpful. On the field, but I can't, I'm not gonna get enough people on the field, so unfortunately, still have to end our phase. You're still not. Can you only attack if Toon World is on the field? No. Because we've already proved that that's not the case. Okay, but now at least we've got another monster we can tribute. Just don't attack again, please. Then I can make something happen. Toon Tail, add one Toon card. Yeah, you're going to do it again. I don't know what the point of you doing that twice is, as opposed to just. And then you get Mega Ryuran. Oh, you've got Toon World. Aha, okay. But still, that benefits me. Because now I can sacrifice for the card that I want. Also, reactivate that. So you may no longer attack me directly, even while I proceed to destroy your monsters. Alright, we got those. And since that's why I'm going to flip these instead. Rather than sacrifice for, like, Gaia and whatnot. Well, activate. I'm thinking that this is going to work. Because you switched that to zero so I can attack it with my monsters now. And since I have Swords of Revealing Light on the field, you can't kill my monsters. Which means that I can basically summon them whenever I want. Tribute them, I should say. Because you do not have any options. Well, now you... Okay, so you're gonna equip my Celtic Guardian to you. But that destroys Horn of the Unicorn, which means you don't get his Horn of the Unicorn boost, thankfully. Okay, so yeah, that gives me that back. Which I can then equip to, which you should have seen. You know how Horn of the Unicorn works, so you know that that strategy is only going to benefit you for like one turn. I can redo Horn of the Unicorn onto Griffor. And then kill Relinquished. I don't care. Oh, but yeah, that gets destroyed instead. Oh, so that's why. But still, even if you continue to do that, I have more life points than you. You're going to run out first. But you are going to then, and then I'll have to, and then... Oh, but that is a problem because now I don't have my... another four-star monster I can use. That is going to ruin things. Mystical Space Typhoon. There was no reason for you to do that. That was like an actually complete waste. But you still can't attack. And I've got one more free turn, so I have to end my phase again. Oh, I just want him to die. I just want him dead. Okay. Four-star monster, please. Oh, but that's actually even cool. Yes. That's also going to destroy Griffor. And you're going to take damage for... You're dead right now. No! Oh, Dark Bribe! Oh, but this. Okay, we're still mildly saved. Because we can special summon. Equal 8 or more. So I will special summon you. I don't need Catapult Turtle for anything. I'm gonna get rid of you. I want Dark Magician more than I want Guy the Fierce Knight, so we'll get rid of you. Attack position. I am not gonna equip it with Horn of the Unicorn, because in the event that it gets destroyed by like Mystical Space Typhoon again, I need to be able to draw a different card. Also, I'm not going to attack Relinquished, because then you'll just equip Magician of Black Chaos to you, so we're going to attack you instead. I'm smart. I know how effects work. You're not going to sink me into your trap. Just please don't use, like, Mystical Space Typhoon on Griffor, so you can friggin' equip me to you. Okay. Okay. 1500 attack. I use a Horn of the Unicorn, that will get rid of that, and then I can kill it for sure with Magician of Black Chaos. That gets rid of Relinquished forever. Let's do it. Because we need to attack it twice. Once per turn. Yeah, once per your turn. That's what I want to make sure that you don't do it during my phase. Alright, and now, goodbye. Ah, oh, that is a weight off my chest. Unfortunately, you've still got Toon World. But you can't attack the turn you're summoned, so there's no way that you can... I think we finally pulled this one out. I think we did. I think we absolutely did. Yes, 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 yes. Maximilian Pegasus has been defeated!
Pegasus, you're finished. We've won. It's impossible. My magic, it all failed me. I've lost.
The duel showed Yugi that the spirit inside the Millennium Puzzle was his friend. Yugi learned that if they worked together, they could accomplish anything.
Spirit of the puzzle, I don't know how to thank you.
It was your courage and the love of your friends had for you, and the love your friends had for you that prevailed this day.
And your determination. We all did it. Together.
That's right. As friends.
And in the end, that's what it came down to. Friends being there for one another.
He won! Way to go!
Yeah! We all won. Thanks, guys!
Yugi saved the souls of his grandpa, Seto and Mokuba. However, there lurked another danger from the shadows. His friend Bakura, still possessed by the evil spirit in the Millennium Ring, had an agenda of his own. So although Yugi thought his problems were over, things were about to get much worse.
Now that Pegasus is weakened by his duel with Yugi, he's given me the opportunity I've been waiting for. The time has finally come for me to add Pegasus's Millennium item to my collection.
Mega Ryuron, Dark Eyes Illusionist, Thousand Eyes Restrict, DP. All right, that's going to do it for this episode. I hope you enjoyed it. Please like, share, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time.